Hello everyone, this is Sabita Sharma, your biology teacher. Let's start our class with short prayer. Dear God, please shower your blessings upon each one of us. Topic for today is ecosystem. What do we mean by ecosystem? Ecosystem is a community of biological surroundings which is in interaction with physical surroundings. Here, biological surroundings are all the living organisms. Okay, all the living organisms which is in interaction with the physical surroundings. And physical surroundings are air, water, light, temperature, land, so on. So, in simple words, ecosystem is a group of living organism, okay, which are in interaction with their physical surroundings like air, water, land, okay, temperature, humidity, and so on. This chapter is all about interaction between living organisms, like how plants and animals interact with each other, how animals interact among themselves, and how these plants and animals interact with their environment. Next, we have types of ecosystem. There are two types of ecosystem. Number one, natural ecosystem, and number two, artificial ecosystem. See, natural ecosystem, the word itself says, natural ecosystem occurs freely in nature. For example, pond ecosystem. When I say pond ecosystem, what are the biological surroundings of pond ecosystem? Frog, fish, tadpole, small aquatic animals, some aquatic plants are the biological surroundings of pond ecosystem. And what are the physical surroundings of pond ecosystem? Physical surroundings are water, light, temperature, okay, dissolved gases which is present in water are physical surroundings of pond ecosystem. And these two surroundings, biological surroundings and physical surroundings, are in interaction with each other, and this forms a system called ecosystem. Likewise, forest ecosystem. When I say forest, what comes in your mind? You imagine trees, plants, some wild animals, birds, okay? These all are what? Biological surroundings of forest. And what are the physical surroundings of forest? Air, water, land, temperature, okay? These are physical surroundings of forest, and these two are in interaction and forms a system called forest ecosystem. Next, we have artificial ecosystem. You see, the word artificial itself says it is made by a man. For example, fish aquarium. Fish aquarium is an ecosystem which has got both biological communities, okay, biological surroundings as well as physical surroundings. Since it is made by a man, it comes under artificial ecosystem. In the same way, garden is also an example of artificial ecosystem. Next, we have interactive components of ecosystem. There are two components of ecosystem. What are they? Biotic and abiotic. You see, the word biotic, B-I-O, bio. Bio means life, living, okay? So all the things which has got life in them, it comes under biotic components. And abiotic, here you see a refers absent of life. So all the things which has no life, okay, it comes under abiotic components. Here we will see how these two components interact with each other. For example, during the process of photosynthesis, plant takes in carbon dioxide and gives out oxygen, which is taken by animals during respiration. Here, both plants and animals are what? Biotic components, and they are in interaction with what? Oxygen and carbon dioxide. And this oxygen and carbon dioxide are what? Abiotic components. As I already mentioned, this chapter is all about interaction, okay? Interaction between abiotic and biotic components. Next we have abiotic components. Abiotic components are the components which has no life in them, which has got no life in them. For example, light, temperature, water, these are some abiotic components. Here we will discuss about how these abiotic components influence the life of biotic components. Let's see. Let's start one by one. Number one, we have light. What do we mean by light? Light is a form of energy. Okay, light is a form of energy. Plants and animals both need light to perform different activities. See, plants and animals, they are biotic components and both need light to perform different activities. For example, plants need light to perform photosynthesis. Okay, plants need light to perform what? Photosynthesis. Plants cannot perform photosynthesis in the absence of light. In the same way, animals, let us take our own example. We prepare vitamin D in our body in the presence of sunlight. Yes, we say that when we stand in the sunlight, we get vitamin D, which is not true. We are not getting vitamin D directly from the sunlight. Okay, it is our own body. Okay, it's our own body that prepares vitamin D in the presence of sunlight. One more example I want to give here. See, we are so active during the daytime. Why we are so active during the daytime? Why we perform a lot of work during the daytime? One of the factors why we are so active during the daytime is light. Okay, due to the presence of a light, okay, we are active during the daytime. So, and one more example, okay, one more example is turning of a plants towards the light, turning of a plants towards the sunlight. So here, light is a biotic factor and a plant is biotic factor, and they are in an interaction. Okay, next abiotic factor, next abiotic component is temperature. What do we mean by temperature? Temperature is the degree of hotness or coldness. How hot or how cold an object is or a the thing is called a temperature. So there are wide range of organisms on this earth which has got its own preference, okay, which has got its own preference for temperature. Some animals, they like high temperature, some like moderate, and some like very cold temperature. For example, this insects and flies, they prefer high temperature, and some animals like polar bear, they prefer low temperature. In the same way, there are some plants which grows well in high temperature, and there are some plants which grow well in low temperature. Next we have water. Now see, both plants and animals need water to perform different activities. Okay, plants need water to perform photosynthesis and other activities. Animals, let us take our own example here also. Since our body itself is made up of 60 to 70% of water, we need water to perform different activities. For example, we need water during the process of digestion. We need water to remove waste products from our body. We need water to maintain thermal balance in our body. So, like this, there are other factors also, okay? There are other abiotic factors, abiotic components like soil, humidity, rainfall, which influence the life of biotic factors. And for that, you can refer your textbook. Next, we have biotic components. Biotic components are the components which has got life in them. For example, plants, animals, microorganisms, all these are what? Biotic components. Next, we have categories of biotic components. There are three categories of biotic components. What are they? Producer, consumers, and decomposers. Producer. What are producer? Producers are the organism, okay? Producers are the organisms which can prepare their own food. For example, green plants. And they are also called autotrophs. Here, auto means a self and trophs means to nourish. Since plants can nourish themselves, they are called autotrophs. Next, we have consumers or heterotrophs. Example, animals. All the organisms which cannot prepare their own food and they depend upon plants directly or indirectly for food are called consumers. They are also called heterotrophs. So heterotrophs are the organisms which cannot prepare their own food and they depend upon plants directly or indirectly for food. Example, animals. These consumers are also three types: primary consumers, secondary consumers, and tertiary consumers. Let me give one example here to understand this. What are these primary, secondary, and tertiary consumers? Okay, imagine a grass. Okay, imagine a grass. A grass is a producer. Okay, suppose grasshopper is eating grass. Here, grasshopper becomes your consumer. Excuse me. Since that grasshopper is feeding directly on that grass. Okay, since it is feeding directly. So grasshopper here becomes your primary consumer. Suppose frog is eating that grasshopper, your frog becomes your secondary consumer. Okay, and if that frog is being eaten by snake, that snake becomes your tertiary consumer. Next, we have decomposers. What are decomposers? Decomposers are microorganisms. Okay, they are especially microorganisms. For example, bacteria, they are present in air, water, and land. What are the roles of this microorganism or decomposers in ecosystem? Decomposers, what they do? They decompose the dead remains of plants and animals in the environment. They decompose, okay, they break down the dead remains of plants and animals in the environment, and it gives back environment the nutrients present in that plants and animals. Okay, so decomposers are helping in recycling the nutrients present in dead remains of plants and animals. Next, we have food chain and food web. Food chain is the series of organisms which are linked together in the process of eating and being eaten. Look at this figure. Food chain is the series of organisms. Here, series of organisms are grass, earthworm, frog, and heron, which are in the process of eating. Here, earthworm is eating grass and being eaten, okay, and being eaten by another organism. And earthworm is being eaten by another organism called frog. So, this is your food chain. Series of organisms which are in the process of eating, okay, earthworm is eating grass and being eaten, okay, and is being eaten by another organism, frog. Next, we have food web. Food web is the network of food chains. Let's see one example to understand this. Look at this example. We have grass, okay. Beetle is eating grass and beetle is being eaten by fox. This is one food chain. And another, we have rat is eating grass and rat is being eaten by owl. Second food chain. And we have grass, rabbit is eating grass and this rabbit is being eaten by owl. So, food chains are somehow interconnected with each other. Okay? You see, there is a relationship between these three food chains. They are somehow interconnected with each other. So, in simple words, food chain, okay? Food web are the network of food chains, okay? They are interconnected with each other. This means when more than one food chains, okay, when one more than one food chains, they interconnect or they interconnect with each other, they make a food web. Next, we have pyramid of numbers and energy flow in ecosystem. Pyramids of numbers. It represents the total number of organism in each trophic level. Total number of organism in each trophic level. So what do we mean by trophic level? Trophic level is the group of organism, okay, which shares same place in food chain. Group of organism which shares same place in food chain. Let's see one example here. Pyramid of numbers. What do we have? Okay, on the base, we have grass, a producer. So, on lowest trophic level, we have grass. And in second, okay, next trophic level, we have herbivores or primary consumers. And in third trophic level, we have carnivores or secondary consumers, which feeds on secondary consumer, which feeds on primary consumer. So, pyramid of numbers are the total number of organisms in each trophic level. Okay, total number of organisms in each trophic level is called pyramid of numbers. Can you see, as we go up, okay, as we go high in the trophic level, the number of organisms keep on decreasing as we go up in the trophic level. Next, we have energy flow in the ecosystem. Here we will discuss about how energy flows in the ecosystem. We all know, look at the figure, we all know that sun is the ultimate source of energy. Yes, we all, okay, all the organisms get energy directly or indirectly from the sun. Now look at this example. Here we have producer plant, okay. This plant is getting energy from sunlight. Okay, how? During the process of photosynthesis, plant traps sunlight. Okay, green color pigment present in the plant traps sunlight. So, plant is getting energy from the sunlight. Oh, sorry. Plant is getting energy from the sun in the form of what? In the form of light energy. Okay. What happens to that light energy in plant during the process of photosynthesis? Plant converts that light energy into chemical energy, which is present in a food. Okay, plant is getting energy from sun in the form of a light. Okay, light energy. It is converting that light energy into chemical energy, and that chemical energy is present in a food. So, when this grasshopper feeds on this plant, it gets its energy from this plant. And when this frog feeds on grasshopper, okay, it gets its energy from from this grasshopper. And when this snake feeds on frog, it gets its energy from frog. This is the flow of energy in ecosystem. Next, we have interdependence between organism. As I already mentioned, this chapter is all about interaction between living organisms. Yes, here we will discuss how living organisms interact with each other. Okay, one form of interaction is symbiosis. It means living together. It means living together. Here, two organisms are in some kind of relationship or in association with each other. There are many forms of symbiotic relationship. Okay, we'll discuss one by one. Number one is parasitism. Okay, parasitism is a relationship between or association between parasites and host. Relationship between parasites and host is called parasitism. So what are parasites? Parasites are the animals or organisms, okay, which live on or in another organism. Okay, for example, lice and human. Lice on human head. So here, lice are the parasites which lives on human head, and human are the host for parasite lice. Parasitism is a kind of a relationship where one organism, that is parasites, okay, parasite gets benefits. Parasites gets its all kind of a benefits from host. In return, host will not get anything from that parasite. It gets harm, okay? Parasites will harm that host organism. So when lice lives on human head, it gives itching sensation. It causes what? Allergic reaction. And when we scratch, okay? When we scratch, we may develop a wound, and it gives chance for another harmful organism like bacteria to invade that place and attack more. So parasitism, we can say it is a kind of a negative relationship or association where one organism enjoys, okay, it enjoys food and shelter on another organism, and in return it gives harm to that another organism called host. Next we have mutualism. You see, the word itself says mutualism, okay? Mutual relationship. Here two organisms live in association, okay? Two organisms are in relationship where both the organisms get some kind of a benefit from each other. For example, honeybee and flowers. Honeybee sucks nectar from flowers, okay? So here honeybee is getting food from flowers, and what benefit that flower is getting from honeybee? When honeybee sucks nectar from flowers, pollen grains, okay, get stuck on its body parts like wings and legs, and when it goes to another flower, it leaves that pollen grains to another flower and helps in pollination. Okay, here honeybee is helping flower, okay, in the process of pollination, and this honeybee is getting food also. Here both the organisms are getting some kind of a benefit from each other. This kind of a relationship is called mutualism. One more example is there. This is one kind of a bird called oxpecker, okay, which lives on the back of a zebra. What it does, it clears, okay, it eats all the organisms like a small insects, a pest which is present on the back of a zebra. Yes, and here see, both the organisms are getting benefit. How they are getting benefit? This bird is getting its food. Yes, this bird is getting food from the back of the zebra, and zebra, what kind of a benefit it is getting from that bird? It is clearing all the germs or organisms which is present on its back. Okay, mutualism is a relationship between two organisms where both the organisms get some kind of a benefit from each other. Next we have commensalism. Commensalism is a kind of relationship where one organism gets benefit, okay, when they are in association, one organism gets benefit and another organism is in neutral. Neither it gets any benefit nor it gets any harm. For example, birds and a tree. See, birds lives on trees, it makes nest, it gets its food from tree. The bird is getting benefit from tree, but in return, tree tree is not getting any benefit, okay, neither it is getting any harm from birds. So commensalism is a kind of association, it's a kind of a relationship between two organisms, okay, where one gets benefit and another organism is in neutral, okay, neither it gets benefit nor it gets any harm. Next we have predation. Predation is a kind of association or relationship between predator and prey for food. Let's see, a predator is an organism that eats its prey. Example, tiger eating deer. Here tiger is a predator and deer is a prey. Let's try to understand this predation with the help of example. With the help of an example, tiger eating deer. Here tiger is a predator. So what are predator? Predator are animals or organism which kills or hunts another organism for its food. And prey are the animals or organisms which are being killed or hunted by another organism. Okay, understood? Next we have cannibalism. Cannibalism is one of the strange or different kind of association or relationship between two organisms, okay, on this earth. Here what happens? Organism eats another organism which belong to same species. For example, spider. Spider eating spider. What happens? When baby spider is hungry and when there is a lack of a food, it eats its own mother. So here spider is eating spider and this spider belongs to same species. Okay, and this association where one organism feeds on another organism which belongs to same species is called cannibalism. Okay, this much for today. Remaining portion we will discuss in our next class. Thank you.